What's up? What's happening? What is going on? Welcome to the first day of semi-clean shaven Cantalupo. We'll see how long this lasts. Only in the rarest of cases would I ever consider someone who leaves a big game early not a bandwagon fan. There are some instances of that in this video, but it's mostly a list of people we can laugh at as they celebrate outside of a stadium they just left. These are eight times bandwagon fans left a game early before their team came back. Number eight, Rangers fans leave early. So these are neither of the Rangers us Americans know. These are the Queen's Park Rangers, a soccer team in England. Their supporters left while the Rangers were down 2-0, I think they call it. The coach was not happy about it.
And that's all you can do. And our fans have gone out. So what I'd like to say to them is you should have stayed. Yeah, our boys need you. You should have stayed. Why didn't you stay? Everybody who did, fantastic. Well done. You deserve that as well. But don't go home early. If you don't want to, stay there.
QPR, as the cool kids say, managed to come back and draw 2-2. Sure, they didn't win, but here's a video of empty seats. And the people who stayed look like they had a lot of fun. Number seven, Raptors fans miss Lowry's miracle shot. One possession game in the playoffs, half the seats are empty. Is something more exciting than a buzzer beater happening in Toronto, Raptors fans?
It's a three-point game. Raptors need a three here to tie it and send it into overtime.
Do they give the foul? I would.
Lowry scoops it up. Lowry lets it fly.
Sure, yeah, the Heat won the game anyway, but come on! Number six, Ducks fans leave the Quack. The Anaheim Ducks always give whatever small fan base they have something to cheer about. They're always in the playoffs and always pulling off big comebacks. Apparently Ducks fans, I guess at least bandwagon Ducks fans, didn't know that in this 2017 playoff game. In a pivotal game five against the Edmonton Oilers, Anaheim trailed 3-0 with just 3 minutes left. Predictably, a number of fans headed for the exit. Just see how few fans remained during this epic comeback.
Still couldn't handle the bouncing puck. It's loose in front. Perry with Talbot down. It's still loose. Puck back in. They score. Ricard. Raquel.
Number five, Arsenal supporters give up. Arsenal faced Reading in a 2012 matchup, but dug themselves into a 4-0 hole. It's hard enough coming back from one goal, but then again, they're playing a team called the Reading, so how hard could it really be? Soccer fans are supposed to be loyal till the end. That's what I hear, right? Supporters ended up missing one of the greatest comebacks in soccer history.
Well, the fourth goal means that some Arsenal fans, we assume, have seen enough and are heading for home already.
Number four, Tampa misses a comeback. The Tampa Bay Rays don't have many fans to begin with. Then, when fans leave critical games early, the trop looks even worse. Like this instance in 2011. It's the last game of the regular season. All they needed was a Red Sox loss and a win at home against the Yankees to punch a playoff ticket. Finally, the place was sold out. It helps they were playing the Yankees. Tampa trailed 7-0, so fans left. Tampa ended up winning on a walk-off, and to be fair, this video still showcases far more fans than I've ever seen in that stadium. Number three, Seahawks fans leave CenturyLink. I would say this woman is an obvious bandwagon fan, but She has a Steven Hauschka jersey on, so it makes me a little bit confused. Trailing the Packers 19-7 in the final minutes of the 2014 NFC Championship game, Russell Wilson threw his fourth interception of the game. That's when fans started to leave. That's also when the Seahawks started to begin their comeback and clinch their spot in the Super Bowl.
What just happened? We got the onside kick with 2 minutes left. 19-14.
Nice. Taylor and her aunt left the game early. As soon as they got to the bottom of the stairs, the Seahawks turned things around.
Beast mode!
As the team started their comeback in the...
Number two, Pats fans missed the Super Bowl victory. The Atlanta Falcons led the New England Patriots 28-3 late in the third quarter of Super Bowl 51. Everyone remembers that. And anyone who hasn't lived through the misery of Tom Brady destroying your team's hopes and dreams for nearly your entire life would think the Patriots had no chance at coming back. So cue Patriots fans, including Marky Mark, Mark Wahlberg leaving, and cue the comeback.
Hand off, touchdown, James White.
What's cool is ESPN published a video where they interviewed a number of fans that chose to leave, and I guess they had somewhat good reasons, superstitious or not, but still, don't leave the game. It's the Super Bowl. You pay like $3,000 for those tickets.
And we asked her to find the game.
All I hear is people saying touchdown Patriots and can't believe that this is happening. There's no words between my dad and I, and we're just sitting in the backseat of an Uber looking at each other.
We knew what each other was thinking. There's a chance they're going to come back and tie this game. And if that happens, we just left the game.
Number one, the Heat bandwagon exposed. There's nothing like sports in Miami. When the Heat, Dolphins, Marlins, or Panthers suck, nobody shows up. When any of them start winning, wow, incredible. They have so many fans. Just ask the Heat. It's the 2013 NBA Finals, and they needed a Game 6 win at home to keep their season alive. Trailing by 5 points with 28 seconds left, their fans left.
Plenty of time, 28.2 remaining. One for two.
I feel bad for them because they missed an incredible ending to the game, and they'll regret it for the rest of their lives.
What exactly did they plan to accomplish leaving 28 seconds early? Is that really going to help them with traffic? What other major comebacks did fans leave early for? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know what you think of clean-shaven Mike. That's actually the most important part. Likes for clean-shaven Mike. Until next time, I'm Mike Cantalupo. Thanks for watching.